So thank you very much to Metro. Thank you very much for their leadership. Given that this is a small crowd, it's being recorded and it's going to history because this is a very important day. We're going to be able to have people that live in the community that are going to be experiencing the mobility of our cities also be part of the design and the creation of a mobile city. And all my students are here, and people that have been supporting us for a long time, professors, advisors, and basically for half an hour, we're gonna record how important this is. This is a very important exercise because the Los Angeles River, Crenshaw Boulevard, many parts of our city are looking for solutions that are innovative and creative. And we all know that the only way to make our city smart, we need to use computation. There's too much things to look at the same time. Engineering drawings, landscape drawings, architecture, community initiatives, grassroots, food initiatives. How can we look at everything at the same time to make decisions about this ecosystem? So one way to do it is to create a virtualization of the existing conditions and the condition it could look like, it could feel like, it could be invested on. How could these buildings be renovated with very little investment into new solutions? So what I'm going to do today, I'm going to show you previous work that we have done, virtualizing campuses and virtualizing cities. And then I'm going to go behind the scenes what we've been doing for Metro Crenshaw LAX. We're actually in the process to virtualize 2,700 buildings along the LAX Metro line and all the stations. So it's a very complex, it looks easy once you look at the movies, and I'm going to start with this first movie, we can play it. This is West Los Angeles College, and this is virtualization, a building information model and geographical information system that captures every single part of the campus, all the way to 1/16 of an inch. Now, what I would like the audience is to imagine, how could we use these information systems and for what purpose? So there's many purposes. You can use it for visualization. First of all, that's why these virtualizations were created. The Los Angeles Community College District will never approve a future building if they didn't see a virtualization. Why? Because a lot of people don't know how to read floor plans. If you look to the top left, it's a beautiful floor plan, but that's not how we experience space. We experience space in three dimensions. So these virtualizations allow us to see how the building is going to look like, how the building looks now, and also how to maintain the building. So this was done by the one program, the $6 million, and actually virtualized all the campuses for LEED certification, LEED energy efficiency of design, and none of the buildings were built if the Board of Trustees didn't get to see this visualization. So first of all, one thing, they're very engaging, right? You can really understand the space. And one of the things that you're gonna see behind the scenes that many people do not understand is that these are actually scientific models. The reason these models look so real is because when actually you put any material into the animation, you gotta put the acoustic level, the kind of reflectivity that the material will have, the lighting, everything is actually very scientific. And that's why this connects to science, it connects to physics, it connects to chemistry, it connects to mathematics. So one thing to take away today is to say, like, if we really want to start looking at complex issues, we have to use the power of computation. And the power of computation allows us to look at natural environment, built environment, and the socioeconomic forces of something as complex as the elemental Crenshaw line. Because there's too many variables. And what happens sometimes in the public, you have people that care about the business, people that care about the parks, people that care about the housing, people that care about the metro. And we're all looking like, ah, but when you actually can all see the same thing, my two cents are illicit because I am seeing it. Right? So this is like a new microscope. The second one I'm going to show you, this is a little bit more connected because this is actually on Crenshaw. We did this animation for West Los Angeles Community Development. And the West Los Angeles wanted to see how the metro line was going to affect one of the buildings, eco building that they are developing. So you can see how this, first of all, it helps you orient yourself. Secondly, it helps you to see how the relationship between the infrastructure and the buildings. So this is going to be something very similar of what we're actually developing for the Crenshaw LAX metro. Very, very similar. And many of them, you can see here how you go down, so you have an aerial view, and then you're going to come down and start seeing the buildings and what is called the fabric. Right? Many of the things in our neighborhoods is that it will take very little to actually beautify some of our buildings. So these are actually mass models, but you can see some of these buildings actually have what is the fabric. And then you can see the travel lanes, the bike lanes. So these are all conceptual. I want you to memorize this. Through the entire presentation, a lot of these virtualizations are still conceptual because we're trying to align all the engineers, all the architects, all the landscape, all the informatics inside these virtualizations. So here you can see an aerial view of that building. So this is something similar in terms of looking at the metro line and then looking at 2,700 buildings that the students that are here virtualized for the Crenshaw LAX. So these two movies kind of gives you a framework of the vision or what we're working on right now for the Crenshaw LAX project. So I'm going to open now a PowerPoint presentation called Behind the Scenes. And I want to, all the architects, all the engineers, the construction companies that are working for Metro, they're extremely helpful and supportive. It's not that easy. It's not that easy to bring all these files together. Because think about it, it used to be that we used to design on 2D. Now we're designing on 3D. So industry going between the 2D and 3D hasn't been an easy transition. And how do you actually organize where are all your toilets, where are all your pipes, where are all your, it's complicated. So that's why it's going to take a lot. That's why this is such an incredible workforce potential for the city of LA. And all we're saying is that our community can help visualize this. And Metro is one of the leaders that are saying, yes, let's use our community to help us visualize how it's going to look like, even at a conceptual level, how important it is and how engaging it is. So working very close with the A7 Architecture Studio, we actually created a smart map for the 8.5 miles, and each student was given a map. And each student became a project manager or a rookie that will be in charge of collecting all the buildings on that block. So there you can see all the miles. When you submit, they actually got smaller and smaller. So the next slide, so there you can see the connection, the relationship between the top of the line to the bottom of the line. And this is what's called a wireframe. So a wireframe, that's kind of like 80% of your time you're going to be looking at things. It's just kind of like the wire, in other words, the frame that is going to do the entire site. So this just looks at the avenues, but it's not showing the buildings next. But they were given by architects and engineers all this information. The landscape, and this is going to be a good sequence. So many times they only give us the sequence, and out of that drawing, we have to interpret based on the specs, how is it going to look like, right? And many times, each of the stations have 4 or 5 proposals for landscape, right? So, by just looking at the 2D and seeing it on the 3D, it can help us say, well, you know, we really want that to look like that. So that's another floor plan, and that's actually virtualization. So we're doing these for all the 8 stations. We're going to fly at 100 feet, go down each of the stations, look around at the station, fly out again, and we're going to do that for 5 minutes, the 8 miles for the Crenshaw LAX. Now, what is very interesting is that, let me see the next one. this is how it's also going to look like. So not only, that's why this is more complex than the second one, because on the Crenshaw LAX project, you're not only going to look at the metro, but you're also going to look at all the buildings, right? And all the fabric, you know, so made out of brick, stucco, cladding, you have landscape. So hopefully, some of these will allow a new economic development for LA Crenshaw line. So next. So that's why I'm calling all of these behind the scenes, because you saw the other two animations, how beautiful they look, right? But the reality is that a lot of people don't understand what is behind it, right? And this is an example of everything that is behind it. That's why I'm calling it behind the scenes. And this animation of the entire 8.5 miles is going to take 3 days to render. And it's going to be the first time that we're actually going to render on the cloud. We don't longer need to have over 25 machines, two servers, like the very first movie I showed you, but this is going to be the first animation that is going to be completely rendered on the cloud. So that's pretty big. So that's another one that I showed you. See here on the left, on the right you can see it from Google Earth, on the left you can see it on SketchUp. So just so you see the detail, each of the students, we hire over 20 students, and each of the students picked a building, and look at it, all the way to a foundation, right? So there's a lot of detail, that's why they look so real, because that's why it's called virtualization, you're actually looking at it. And this is another one for the wireframe. So it's a tremendous, that's another one, that's why I call it behind the scenes. So if you want to leave that one on the screen as we talk about it. So what I thought for the rest, I think I have another 10, 15 minutes. I want the students to share their experience. I want them to share with us what they learned, what they found exciting, and I give a perspective to, for the people that are here and for the recording to kind of memorialize, right, and make history of today that Metro and government agencies are really looking at people that live in the community as a different type of workforce. Designers, creators, technologists, and I feel very proud. I feel very proud after 25 years of working on this issue. So, really quick, I'm Marcela Oliva, architectural professor. We basically have a studio at LA Trade Tech where I call it community-based education, where our projects are real projects to serve the community. So, the students had to work with SketchUp and Google Earth, and then they were brought into 3D Studio. And in 3D Studio, it was connected with the rail system and with all the infrastructure and all the topography with it. So now I'm going to start. I think I'm going to probably. Do we have a microphone that I can just walk around? So I think, Ken, I will pause 2 seconds. And